Blackstone Publishing presents A Touch of the Grape by Claudia Bishop. This book is read by Justine Eyre. For Helen Stanton, with love and admiration for your 83 years of talent. 1. The dog peered around the corner of the garden shed. It was a large dog, sort of a yellowish-brown with large lop ears and big feet. He cocked his head at the three women facing him, whined, and ducked back out of sight. Sarah Quilliam, known as Quill, had called the Humane Society when she'd noticed the dog had left blood on the fountain in the center of their herb garden.
"Somebody kicked it, undoubtedly," said Selena de la Vega Summerhill. "Right over the kidneys. My guess is that the damage is there." She sighed. "I've seen too many abused animals since I've started working at the shelter. It's terrible the way they treat animals."
She was a lovely woman in her late 30s. Her Spanish accent was slight.
"The way who treats animals?" Meg Quilliam demanded. She nudged her sister affectionately. "Quill's been feeding it. She doesn't think I've noticed, but I have. My beef merengo, if you can believe it. So it isn't terrible the way Quill treats animals. Not when this particular animal gets a stew that's been rated the best in 50 states.
Meg got the third star back from L'Aperitif, Quill said to Selena. After that trip to Florida earlier this year.
So we heard, Selena smiled. And you heard, I think, that our Summerhill Chardonnay took second place in the wine growers' competition this year.
Her warm olive skin took on a rosier glow.
No, Meg said. That's great, Selena. Who says upstate New York's in a depression? Award-winning wines, award-winning chefs.
She scowled suddenly.
So how come neither of us has any business? How come you, Selena, as part owner of one of the largest wineries in central New York, has to take a job as the town dog catcher to help make ends meet? How come Quill has to?
Because upstate New York's in a depression, Quill said abruptly.
Come on, guys, what about the dog?
She whistled. The dog stuck its head through the azaleas planted to the right of the shed door and barked once. Then he flopped over on his side and yawned. One scarlet petal drifted down from the bush and settled over his right eye. It didn't add anything to his looks. He was still the most unprepossessing mutt Quill had ever seen.
I have this leash sort of thing, Selena said. It's a collar attached to a pole. I'll get it. You, Quill, get some of Meg's stew. Meg, talk to it so it will stay here while we fetch these things.
Talk to it? Meg ran one hand through her short, dark hair. Talk to it? What sort of things do you say to a dog?
Call him querido, Selena suggested. Talk to him of lady dogs.
I don't know. You're the dog catcher, Meg said. If you don't know, who does?
Selena shrugged.
I've only had the job a few days. I'm in training.
So where's the person that's supposed to be teaching you how to catch dogs?
Laid off, Selena said. Budget cuts, they said.
How much does it pay? Quill asked, thinking catching dogs might be a far easier job than catching non-existent guests in a depressed economy. The dog growled.
Not enough, Selena said, her voice quivering slightly. But I got there first, Quill.
Selena, I mean, we're not that desperate.
Well, we are, Selena said grimly. Hugh, he is most unhappy that I have this job, but we cannot sell enough wine. And you know the people that bought his clothing business?
I didn't know Hugh had a clothing business.
Oh, yes, not very fancy clothes, you understand. The more inexpensive lingerie and the women's pantsuits of, what do you call it? It's fake.
Polyester, Meg said.
Polyester. This is where I met Hugh, of course. I was a runway model. As I said to Hugh, a woman who has been a runway model for cheap lingerie does not mind being a dog catcher. He did not seem to like that much.
She giggled. Quill said, floundering. She didn't know Hugh Summerhill very well, but she had heard his family was from upper-class Boston. He looked the part, that was for sure.
About this dog.
Selena pushed a tendril of black hair from one eye.
You must keep its attention, Meg. While Quill obtains a bribe, it is the way of the world. Even dogs must be bribed. I will sneak up on it and be ready to pounce. But first, I will get...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.